Hi and welcome to The Tough Question, where we approach an expert with a head scratcher so you can better understand China. Since 2012, the Communist Party of China has intensified its efforts to tackle corruption at all levels, famously targeting both tigers and flies. But why has so much emphasis been put on rooting out corruption, and what progress has been made? Here's Xia Lu from the School of Marxism Studies at Renmin University of China.
Anti-corruption, very interesting question, and that's my favorite. We'll be talking about this question today. The construction of a party work style and a clean government, as well as the fight against the corruption, concern the life and death of the party, which requires the endeavors of the entire party. For state, it is about security. For society, it is about stability. And for the people, it is about everyone's life and their faith in the public sectors, which in turn is conducive to the security and social stability. How has the Chinese authority tackled the issue of corruption? First of all, key institutions are strengthened and formed to make sure that there are consistent efforts to persevere in never-ending fight against the corruption. Secondly, keeping regular and a routine intra-party inspection and exercising strict governance of the party. Thirdly, promoting a combination of intra-party supervision and public scrutiny. The CGTN, China's top anti-corruption body, has stressed that there should be continued efforts in tackling corruption problems troubling Chinese people's lives in certain fields. Well, this includes, but not limited to, education, medical care, health care, social welfare, and poverty alleviation. Well, this was to make sure that people see justice and fairness in every judicial cases. Anti-corruption efforts in the financial sectors, state-owned enterprises, and the political and the legal systems will continue to be enhanced as well. The country will also strengthen international cooperation in this kind of fight against the corruption and tracking down the fugitives and recovering their assets and those kind of illegal monies. Under these new circumstances, the CPC has pledged to make political building the primary task in ensuring full and strict governance over the party and launch targeted political supervision regularly. Concrete and specific efforts are needed in enforcing full and rigorous party self-discipline so as to ensure that the CPC Central Committee's decisions are faithfully and fully implemented and fulfilled, and that the party marches forward as one.
So thanks to Dr. Xia Lu for his perspective on China's anti-corruption drive. To sum up, he really sees the approach as vital to the workings and indeed the success of the party, ensuring that across China the people have a sense of justice and fairness, that everyone has to play by the rules, no matter who they are or where they work. See you soon for the next Head Scratcher.